So hi everybody, my topic is regarding ARM controller and microcontroller and its application. So before starting ARM controller, so since it is I'm going to deal with ICs, so mainly ICs are classified into two types. One is a general purpose and another one is specific purpose. So in general purpose, microprocessors come under that, and in specific purpose processor, we have a lot of controllers like microcontroller, ARM controllers. So ARM is a company name. It is actually a 32-bit microcontroller, and is a RISC-based. So ARM stands for Advanced RISC Machine. So ARM is actually a company. It has given nowadays it has given a license to many companies, Motorola, or it may be Atmel, or it may be some other. So mainly Philips, a company called Philips, is manufacturing processor nowadays. So I am going to concentrate on LPC2148 because since it has got many features in that. Coming to internal structure, it has got many inbuilt hardwares. So first of all, let me tell you, the first one is barrel shifter. So what it will do is, so barrel shifter, as the name itself indicate, it will do this shifting operation. So it may be either left shift or right shift, or in that, again, two types. It may be logical or arithmetical. And we have, unfortunately, we have only one rotate operation, rotate right. We don't have rotate left. It's a main disadvantage, I would like to say. So regarding, let me tell you how it works. So first, let me take adding two numbers. Simple example, let me take. So I'm going to add two numbers, 2 plus 1, 3, right? It's a simple one, but in fact, so I want to modify a second operand. So we have a barrel shifter that will do the modification in the second operand. So first, what we'll do is, the second source operand will be directly given to the barrel shifter. So it will do either, as per the requirement, it will do the left shift operation or right shift operation. And after shifting the second operand, then it will give to the ALU, arithmetic logical unit. And the first source operand is directly given to the ALU. So then ALU, depending upon the operand we have specified, it will do the operations. So the result of ALU is a result. 2 plus 1 is 3. So next one we have is conditional instructions. So here, we do not check a condition after performing each and every operations. So before conditioning, before doing any operation, at the same time, simultaneously, we can check the condition and do the operation. So if I take move BL, A,R1, okay? So first it'll check whether the first operand and source and destinations are less than or greater. If it is less than, then it will do the move operations. So next, regarding its inbuilt features. So it has got many inbuilt hardwares like ADC. So it is 10-bit ADC, so that it can access analog signal and it convert into a 10-bit signals. Next one is DAC, a digital to analog converter. It is an 8-bit DAC, so that what it can convert a 8-bit digit into analog signal. So next it has got RTC, real-time clock. So that what, whenever a processor is not getting any excitation or voltage, it can do the operation without any external power supply. So next thing, the operation of RTC can be controlled by clock frequency. So it has got inbuilt clock with frequency 32 kilohertz. So next one, coming to its clock signal. So let me tell you one thing. The constraint we have here is only two cases. One is operation, another one is speed. The speed of the any microcontroller. I am not concentrating on ARM. So if you take any microcontroller, the speed of the controller is decided by its clock frequency. Now the question is how we can control the clock frequency. So as an electronic person, I can by reducing a clock cycle, we can reduce the we can increase the or enhance the speed. So now question is how we can reduce the machine cycles. So there is one concept called pipelining. So pipelining is the concept where we can execute more than one instruction simultaneously, I mean in a parallel manner. So while doing pipelining, it is following three stages. First one is a fetching, next one is decoding, then executing. First, let me take three instructions. So adding, moving, and multiplications. So each, in order to execute each instruction, it has to follow one by one. It has to follow first fetching, decoding, and executing. So let me take first example, add. So first it will do the fetching operation. In fetching, it will take the mnemonics and decoding, it will convert into convert whatever assembly language you return, or it may be assembly language or C language, it will convert into machine language. Then it will do the operation according to that code. So second one, at the same time, when it is doing decoding of first instruction, it will do the fetching of second instructions. So next, the first instruction will be following, execution, and in the meantime, second instruction will do the decoding, and in the meantime, the third instruction will do the fetching. So that we can, I can save 2 cycles here. So as a result, what? We can enhance the speed also. So thank you.